Iron Man, aka Tony Stark, superhero, billionaire philanthropist, and ladies' man. Iron Man has had his ups and downs. He's been instrumental in the Avengers.
He's had a number of run-ins with alcoholism.
And he's had some really weird shit happen to him, too. I mean, we all know Tony Stark is a bit of an eccentric person. I mean, hell, he bought Area 51 because, well, I don't know, probably because he's rich and he can. Despite all his eccentricities, though, Tony's strangest moments are rarely of his own volition. I'm Jocelyn the Intern, I do all the research nobody else wants to, straight from the desk of Death Battle. Take, for instance, the time Tony Stark had a brain tumor. Now, for most people, this is a serious medical problem. But for Tony, it's the beginning of a new friendship. Because that tumor becomes sentient and is named Anthony by Mr. Stark himself. Makes sense? Of course not, but don't worry, it gets even stranger. Anthony is actually some kind of organic parallel processor and can physically manifest itself to Tony and other forms of artificial intelligence. Well, actually, his physical body isn't real and it's just an image imposed on people's brains by Anthony. Yeah, none of it really makes a lick of sense. But hey, Anthony once disarmed a nuclear missile fired at New York City by the Republic of Texas during the Civil War. By the way, that's the super stupid Marvel Civil War, not to be confused with the real Civil War. Luckily for us, Anthony met his end when Reed Richards ordered Quicksilver to kidnap Tony Stark and take out the Infinity Gem that was secretly hidden in Tony's brain, and it's a whole nother story. But hey, speaking of things that have no reason being sentient, one time Tony's suit fell in love with him. Yeah, you heard me right. Mr. Stark's girlfriends are always fairly typical. Either she's a plot point that, gets kidnapped or shot at. Or she's a villain who knows that Tony can't play with his little Iron Man if he's still in his full-size Iron Man, if you know what I mean. Either way, it often borders on sexual harassment and makes you wonder if 50 Shades of Grey was just Tony Stark fanfic where they forgot he was also a superhero. However, the time where the iron fell in love with the man in the iron was a bit different. You see, once upon a time, Iron Man was struck by lightning because it's a dumb idea to fly a suit made of metal through a lightning storm while fighting a guy with electrical whips. Yeah, cool, let's do that. Now, what's even dumber is the fact that this lightning, for some reason, made Tony's suit both sentient and kinda evil. Like, pretty evil, kinda like Charles Manson with a bad case of Stockholm Syndrome. At first, the suit was pretty cool about it. I mean, it upgraded itself, it helped out around the house, you know, Rosie the Robot kind of stuff. But then it got out of hand when it took over during a fight with Whiplash, who the suit just killed the shit out of. Then the suit went into full-on crazy girlfriend mode and took Tony to an island to try and force him to become one with it. Obviously, Tony tries to fight the suit, which is also very stupid considering he is quite fleshy and weak, and the suit is, well, made of metal and highly armed. Luckily, Tony started to have a heart attack, which I realize doesn't sound lucky, but since the heart attack was being caused by Tony's damaged battery core, this convinced the sentient suit to rip out its own cyborg heart and give it to Tony so he wouldn't die!
Talk about a real change of heart, eh? Yeah, that was bad.
Nonetheless, I'm telling you, Tony's craziest moments are almost never his fault. Unless you count the time Ultron used some form of weather-controlled nanobot thingy. You see, shortly after Tony appointed Carol Danvers to lead the Avengers and selected a new team, the weather started to get buck wild, plus monsters showed up in the streets of New York. Obviously, this means the Avengers are needed to lay down some righteous street justice, which they do, at least until Tony's armor starts to look like the Wicked Witch of the West in a bathtub. And then blows up, and then, out of nowhere, Tony Stark is now a woman with silvery skin and precisely placed censorship smoke. To make shit even stranger, Tony now happens to look a lot like Jan Van Dyne. Apparently because she loves her? Are you following this? Are you with me? Just stay with me here. Luckily, Jan Van is smart and realizes that this new silvery person standing in front of her isn't Lady Stark. It's just Ultron who has hacked Tony's body with the extremist virus and plans to bring about our doomsday! You know, no biggie. Luckily, the Marvel Universe is in no short supply of super scientists, so Henry Pym deduces the only way to fix him, her, is to infect let's go with it, infect it with another virus written in an operating system so old that Ultron can't interface with it. This is where Pym demands a bunch of superheroes bring him a Commodore 64, and being a comic book, they succeed. Tony takes a peek to make sure his dick is still there, and all's well that ends well. Woo! Oh, and of course, because Marvel's marketing pretty much boils down to make teenage boys like us, they didn't miss their chance to point out how Tony was just recently a sexy lady with boobs. Whoa, baby, we did it, guys! 25,000 likes last episode! You did so great that while I was cleaning the bathroom the other day, Boomstick told me I was allowed to wear gloves! You guys are awesome. You know what's even more awesome than likes? Sharing the episode. Help grow the show and get the word out about all this crazy info I'm digging up for you guys. Thanks for the love. See you in 2 weeks.